I be popping. I'll up this fucking pistol. Here we damn go. This is the one they remember me for. Race to round one damn 100. And we skipped the first 50 rounds because that's some bullshit. The epic road. Finally. After all those round one downs on Shadows of Evil, I can finally prove myself to the people that I am not just the average Zombies player, but that I can ascend to greatness. Relaxing end. You better watch out, buddy, because I'm coming to steal the crown. I will be the very best at catching in Call of Duty Zombies, and I will make sure that I can always 100% get to round one. Damn shit! Are you kidding me? Did I even get? I couldn't even see my levels, man. The UI error. What the hell was that? Okay, man. But you know what? The level 200 perks, getting all these power ups. You know that's pretty nice, my man. Anyways, guys, how's it going, Mr. T back? And in today's video, I'm gonna be showing you guys how I essentially got to round 80 by camping. And it's so crazy because this is like honestly unheard of, except for damn Buried. But Buried can suck a dick because I hated Buried. But Der Eisendrache, you can get to round 80. Just by camping with the Stormbolt where I am located. It is so easy to do, guys. Unfortunately, as you guys can see with King Excel here, I don't have my Quick Revive because I suck. Like, I lost my first Quick Revive at round 6, and I was like, okay, I've restarted so many damn times. Should I go again? Should I go again? I was like, you know what? Let's go again. And then I died at round 6, and then it was just like, you know what? Fuck it, I'm just gonna stay here, and we're just gonna play the rest of the game. But yeah, guys, this strategy is so damn simple. Essentially, all you really need to learn how to do is to be able to camp, which is pretty easy. You just don't move the damn controller. Get the Wrath of the Ancients, get the Storm Bow, get the Wolf Bow, get the Shield, get the DG4, and that is essentially it. And then, honestly, to kill Panzers with this strategy, just camp here, and then pull out a Haymaker, or if you can't get the Haymaker from the box immediately, just go buy a KRM, upgrade it, and get Blast Furnace, and you will eradicate everything. Use the Storm Bolt for the zombies, and use the shotgun for the Panzer. It is a surprising how much damage it actually does against the Panzer. When you're shooting at the Panzer, keep in mind that this Panzer is different from the one in Origin, so you have to shoot its chest to actually kill it faster. Where the damn power core is, I can't even breathe just because of that stupid damn ass Panzer. But yeah, such an easy strategy. You guys, I highly recommend it. It is a little tiny bit better than my round 50 strategy. The only problem is there's a lot of fast spawning. I think this is the place where it has the fastest spawning in the game. But the thing is with this, you have to know how to keep up with the whole massive hordes of zombies that are coming at you very, very quickly. And you have to sort of hoard around with the Storm Bow, show your back where the riot shield is to the zombies so they hit the riot shield rather than hitting you. There's a lot of little tactics that you have to learn, and when the Panzer comes, trap down the DG4 and then just unload with your KRM. It'll take care of the zombies, you'll take care of the Panzer, and if that doesn't work, then just go to the death ray and kill him there. It's so easy. I highly recommend the Haymaker over the KRM if you can get it, though, because like even at round 100, round 80, what I was at, I was able to take him down pretty damn simply. But the KRM is good up until about round 50, and then you're gonna want to be switching it out, because I, as you can see here, I basically have 800,000 points. You can't get the damn Haymaker with that type of money. You got some bad luck. You got some Lex luck over there. Okay, guys, but that is pretty much it for today's video. It's a very simple strategy. The only reason I die is because I suck, and honestly, just continuously use your DG4s. The only thing I have to say to you guys is watch how you use the Storm Bow, because sometimes it can lag you out, especially in the higher rounds, and honestly, it is very difficult to be able to control this. So if you do get some type of error, that is just because of the bow, and maybe because of the traps. And after round 80, honestly, you can just hoard around where the sort of regular dragon is at the speed cola. You could just go there, hoard around with the trap, and you'll basically get to round 100, no problem. And they said they nerfed the Storm Bolt, but I don't see it. I don't see damn shit. It is so amazing, and I highly, highly recommend this strategy. Very fast. I got all my stuff out by round 24, and I stayed here till round 80, and it was just amazing. And again, make sure you have the shield while you're here. Make sure you have Alchemical Antithesis, so when you're running low on the Storm Bolt, eat the Gobblegum, and you'll just get full ammo. Get the cashback Mega Gobblegum for max ammo. That's gonna really help out as well. Get Pop Shocks just in case for the Panzer. Get Immolation Liquidation or Head Drama or Perkaholic. And lastly, just get whatever you want. Those are the only two Gobblegums I would really suggest. Alchemical and the Max Ammo Gobblegum. But that's pretty much it. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy, please make sure to leave a like. I'm going to be trying to get to round damn 100. This took around 5 hours for the strategy, which is quite quick considering it's round 80. That's ridiculous. Like, you can camp till round 80. Like, you don't hoard literally at all. You don't hoard at all. Again, I also recommend the Wolf Bow just in case you want to get the Panzer Helmet. So while all these zombies are coming at you, you got a Panzer coming at you, you can use your Wolf Bow, shoot the Claw, and then you can get the Panzer Claw Helmet to help you stay sort of prone to the Panzers. And it's an amazing idea. Get the Fire Plunger if you want. I don't really recommend it, especially if you're playing solo, but co-op, definitely go for it. But thank you guys so much. If you did enjoy, like I said, please make sure to leave a like. Thank you again, and I will see you in the next one.